All right, today I want to talk to you about something really quite specific, and it's something a lot of my clients have been asking me about when it comes to SEO. For those of you who do not understand what SEO is, I'm not going to try and explain it now. I'm just going to refer you to a book on my website. This is timlevy.net. And if you go to this particular page here, this book here called The Google Gamble, that is a beginner's explanation of what SEO is about and how to resolve it without having to learn all of the techniques yourself. This particular problem came with a client of mine who was having problems with SEO and really wasn't finding their way into the front page, let alone the top ranking number one result with Google rankings. So when that particular company typed in their name on Google, it didn't show up on the page at all, which I'm having a little do right now. In fact, you had to know enough about this company to know what the initials stood for to even get to it. And you can see here, it's not finding it in Google. This is a really low traffic website. This particular company is called PCI, standing for Precision Cut, which just doesn't come up with Google at all at this point. And there is their website, which is set up for them by somebody else. Now, one of the issues, and there were many, was that this website was not what's called W3C compliant, which is another way of saying it wasn't correct code. So if we go to Google here and we type in WC3 validator, which you can see is the first thing that Google wants you to type, we come up to the W3C markup validation service, which is basically a website that helps you know if there are any problems with your code. And what you do is you take the URL of your website, in this case precisioncart.com, and you paste it into where it says address here and you hit check. And when you do, it goes through the site and finds out if there are any problems with that one page. In this case, the page, which is the home page, has 27 coding errors and 42 warnings. That's not what you want. And the problem with this is when you have so many errors and warnings, Google tends to respect your site a little less and throw you down in the rankings. So it's just one of those things you can do to actually get up in Google's rankings. It's not the only thing. It's not even the most important thing. It's just a good thing to look out for because so few people actually bother to do it. So if you look down here, it actually lists out all of those errors. Here are the 27 errors, and on it goes. And it's just naming little code errors that are very fixable within the HTML code or the WordPress site. These things are so fixable. And as you fix them, they pop off this warnings list until you get, instead of a red thing here, you get a green thing. So for example, here I am on the Google Gamble page for my website. I go to my validator, there it is. Go and grab the URL from the Google Gamble, pop it in by cutting and pasting and hit check, and boom, it comes in with a green, which is the most successful you can have. What you want is something that's green. What you don't want is something that's red. If you get a red, you can put your web coding team or your SEO team onto actually fixing these errors. And when you do, I have noticed it is very effective in raising your website when it comes to Google. For example, if I put in Tim Levy, you'll see I have the very top spot and several of the other spots as well. And that's an outcome I'm sure you're all keen on having.